This is new video from topic thermodynamics. It is fourth topic from 12th science physics HSC board. Okay, so this is next video. In this we are going to study what is thermodynamic process, thermodynamic variables, what is heat, how internal energy is changed, like that. Okay, so we will start with what is thermodynamic process. Okay, the process in which thermodynamic state of a system is changed is known as thermodynamic process. So, for example, consider a vessel containing water. So, if this vessel is heated externally, that means heat is supplied to the vessel externally, we know that water starts boiling. Okay, so steam formed, it exerts pressure on the wall of the container, wall of vessel. So here state of system is changed. It is nothing but thermodynamic process. Okay, so when the steam exerts pressure on the wall of container, here in this process we know that the quantities such as pressure P, volume V and temperature T are changed. Okay, so these are known as thermodynamic variables. Okay, so these are variables which change when the state of system is changed. That means during the thermodynamic process. Okay, so next article we are going to see again is heat. Heat is nothing but energy transferred due to temperature difference between system and environment. There is temperature difference between system and environment. Consider a cylinder containing gas. Okay, it is having suppose piston which is massless, frictionless, it is moving inward and outward. Okay, so like this you can consider a cylinder. So here gas in the cylinder is our system. Gas in the cylinder is our system and the other remaining part is our environment. Suppose TS is less than TE, that means temperature of system is less than temperature of environment. So here heat flow, energy flow takes place from environment to the system. Environment to the system. If Q is the energy transfer here, Q is the energy transfer here, energy transfer is from environment to the system, that means into the system, environment to the system, that means into the system. So here Q is positive, heat is flowing into the system, so Q is positive here. Okay, so in next case, see here, if TS is greater than TE, temperature of system is greater than temperature of environment. Therefore, heat flows from system to the environment. See here, TS is greater than TE. Temperature of gas is greater than that of environment. So, heat flows from the system to the environment. That means system loses energy. So system gives its energy to the environment. That means system loses its energy. Therefore Q is negative. Q is negative. See, so here energy transfer is from system to the surrounding. If both are at same temperature, that means system and environment both are at same temperature, that means they are in thermal equilibrium. So there will be no energy transfer. So Q is equal to zero. Thus heat is nothing but energy that is transferred due to temperature difference between system and its environment. Next point is how internal energy of a system can be changed. Okay, so internal energy of system can be changed by two ways. First one is by heating the system, and second one is by doing work. Okay, first we will consider change in internal energy by heating the system. Consider a gas in a cylinder, so it is kept in contact with body at higher temperature. Suppose the gas is here, the gas is our system, other relevant parts are environment. Okay, so the cylinder is heated externally. Okay, heat is supplied to the cylinder. Initially, suppose its temperature is 100 degrees Celsius. So when the heat is supplied to the gas, its internal energy increases and the temperature of the system increases. That means its internal energy also increases. It becomes, suppose, 200 degrees Celsius. So this is one way of changing the internal energy of the system. Okay, we will see another way. So it is by doing work on the system. So see here, consider a gas contained in enclosed in a cylinder. The cylinder is having massless, frictionless piston which is movable. Okay, so if initially the gas is at 100 degrees Celsius, so if the piston is moved inwards, okay, the piston is moved inwards quickly. Okay, so here the work is done by the piston on the gas. Gas is compressed. Work is done by the piston on the gas. Okay, so here change in internal energy of the system takes place. Internal energy of the system is increased and its temperature becomes 200 degrees Celsius. So here change in internal energy is occurred because of external work done by the piston on the gas. When the piston is moved inside, when the piston is moved into the gas. Okay. Suppose in other case, if the piston is moved outwards, okay, if the piston is moved outwards, then work is done by the gas on the piston. Work is done by the gas on the piston, and there will be decrease in its internal energy. That means the gas cools down. Okay, so thus change in internal energy is occurred by doing work. Change in internal energy can be obtained by heating the system or by doing work. Next article is first law of thermodynamics. So to study first law of thermodynamics, we have to consider again the same example, that is gas is enclosed in a cylinder. Ideal gas is enclosed in a cylinder. The cylinder is having massless, frictionless, movable piston. Okay, so the gas is our system and the piston and other relevant things are our environment. Suppose the amount of heat supplied to the system is Q. Q is the amount of heat supplied to the system. Then its internal energy increased by amount delta U, and the remaining part is lost in the form of work done. Okay, so see here, the statement can be written mathematically as Q is the amount of heat supplied. It is used up in two ways. So first one is to increase its internal energy, and second one is work done during expansion. This work done, we are going to see this work done as PdV. Okay, so heat supplied is used in two ways. So to increase its internal energy and to do work on the surrounding. Okay, so to explain this, again we will consider the same example. Suppose the piston is moved outwards. So this is the direction of piston. So if the piston is moved outwards, so here the molecules of gas will exert pressure on the piston. They will give its momentum. They will give their momentum to the piston. Okay, so there will be positive work done by the gas on the piston. Positive, their work done will be positive. Work done is by the gas on the piston. Okay, so in second case, if the piston is moved inside, then this piston will push the molecules of gas. It will exert momentum on the molecules of gas. So there will be work done by the piston on the gas. Work done will be by the piston on the gas. So this work done is negative work done. Okay. So if the cross-sectional area of piston or the cylinder is capital A, the force exerted by the piston will be force is equal to pressure into area. So work done during this displacement dx of the piston, work done for the displacement dx of the piston dw is equal to integral pdv. Okay, if vi is its initial volume, if vf is the final volume of the gas, then integration from vi to vf of pdv. So it can also be written as p in bracket vf minus vi. Therefore, energy supplied to the system is used to increase its internal energy and to do the work. Okay, so this is nothing but first law of thermodynamics. Okay, next article is property of system or system variable. Okay, property of system, that is system variables. So when the system is in equilibrium, its measurable or observable characteristics, properties, are nothing but system variables or properties of system. So when the system is in equilibrium, its measurable, observable characteristics, properties, are nothing but states of variables or system variables. Okay, so here the properties of systems are pressure, volume, temperature, density. These are properties of system. So these properties are of two types. First one is intensive variables. Second one is extensive variables. Intensive variables, that means the variables which do not depend on the size of system. Extensive variables, they depend on the size of the system. Suppose a system is taken, it is divided into two equal parts. Okay, so we know that pressure, temperature and density of system will not change even if its size is changed. That means these variables are not depending on the size of system. They are intensive variables. But if when the system is divided into two parts, its mass is changed. Okay, its internal energy is also divided into two equal parts, and hence these are extensive variables. Okay, so these are system variables, that means properties of system.